My name is Alexander Theologis. I also go by Alekos Theologis. I'm a fourth year orthopedic surgery resident at University of California, San Francisco, or UCSF. And we are in the Orthopedic Trauma Institute at San Francisco General Hospital. In the Marcucio Lab, we're working with the tibial osteotomy model and looking at the effects of endocrine-disrupting chemicals that are prevalent throughout the environment. And we're trying to see if they have an effect on fracture healing, whether they inhibit it altogether or they slow the process. The particular chemical that we're studying right now is BPA, bisphenol A, which is in the public press quite a bit. It's known to be in baby bottles and other plastic materials. So the thought is it affects estrogen signaling, which is known to be important for fracture healing and bone maintenance and growth in general. And the thought is that because of that connection, that BPA may alter the normal process of bone healing. I was born in St. Louis, Missouri. I moved out to the South Bay in California, to Palo Alto, when I was about 2 years old. My parents were both in the science world. My dad was a plant biologist, and my mom is an OBGYN, but has a focus in basic science research on endometriosis. Because of them, there was a large scientific focus growing up, but nonetheless, they supported me going into anything that I please. But since a young age, I've been interested in science. Current day consists of exposing the specimen to this specific chemical, BPA, and doing this every day for 3 weeks total. At different time points throughout those 3 weeks, we take the specimen and then are able to analyze the genes that are being expressed at that time point, as well as slice it into different smaller sections, smaller layers, and then looking at specific cells under the microscope after coloring them with different dyes. And we're doing this for the specimens that are exposed not only to the chemical, but to nothing. And so that's the way we have a comparison of which ones, if this chemical is really having an effect. The goal of this research, or the vision of this research, is if we can detect if one of these chemicals affects fracture healing, if we can measure the levels in human blood, which has been done before and shown to be present in most individuals, at least in the United States, and if we can see if there's a certain level that's associated with poor fracture healing, if we somehow could modify the environment that they live in by not having them use certain products, then that may bring their level down, and that may help them or prevent them from not healing. In addition to the other scientists in the lab and having the ability to talk with them, the day-to-day hands-on work is exciting as well. Working with the specimens is, it's fun, it's different every day, which keeps it exciting, and there's obstacles in the lab. Not every day does something work, and when something doesn't work, it's important that you try to think about why it didn't work and try to come up with answers of how you can fix it. It makes the process enjoyable to try to problem solve, and that problem solving sometimes works and sometimes doesn't. So it's really an ongoing challenge, but that challenge is fun.